Hello, year 11 students, my ever hardworking students. You're welcome on board to a review of some of the topics you have covered in IGCSE chemistry. Today, we want to talk about organic chemistry, homologous series, and alkane. We just want to give a brief description of these concepts. What is an organic chemistry, organic compound? What we are talking about is organic compound, homologous series, and alkane. What is an organic compound? An organic compound is a compound containing carbon, hydrogen, and some few elements like oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, and halogens. But the main backbone of organic compound is carbon, then joined with hydrogen. Now, organic compounds are so numerous that it is difficult for any chemist to start studying all of them one by one. Therefore, they are grouped into different families with similar properties. This now leads us to the concept of homologous series. A homologous series is a group or family of organic compound with the same functional group, similar physical and chemical properties. A homologous series is a family of group of organic compounds with the same functional group and similar physical and chemical properties, which means any family of a particular homologous series will have a general property that is similar to the other. Now, what are the examples of homologous series? The common examples: 1, alkane; 2, alkane; 3, alcohols, carboxylic acid, esters, amines, benzene, and so on and so forth. There are so many, even the families, but at the concept of IGCSE, we will limit it to these ones. Then, what are the properties of a homologous series? That is, if you pick one homologous series like alkane now, what are those things we are going to observe? 1, they all conform to the same general molecular formula. They all have the same functional group. They all show similar physical and chemical properties. Each member differs from the next by CH2. That is, successive members differ by CH2. If you pick the first member, you only need to add CH2 to it to form the second member, and so on and so forth. Now, boiling point, melting point, vaporization point, etc., and density, they increase with increasing number of carbon as you are going down the group, and they are becoming bigger. Those things start becoming larger. Then there is a gradation from gaseous state to liquid to solid, which means the largest of a particular group are usually solid. You'll be shocked that the largest of an organic compound, of organic acid, is solid. Some of them start as gases, like alkane now. The first members, four members, are gases, the cooking gas that you use at home, methane, ethane, propane, butane, are all gases. From pentane, they start becoming liquid, to the one having carbon 19 or thereabout, liquid. After carbon 20, they become solid. So there is a gradation in physical state from gas to liquid and to solid. Now, let's look at some concepts again that we have been mentioning. I know someone will have been saying, what is functional group? Though you must have done it before. A functional group is a structure, it's a bond or atom found in all members of a particular homologous series, upon which the properties of that homologous series depends. For instance, alkanes have functional group or single bond. Akin double, Akin triple, alcohol OH, carboxylic acid COOH, amines NH2, esters COO, and so on and so forth. Let's talk about homologous series of alkanes. Alkanes, ANEs, they have the general formula CnH2n+2, CnH2n+2. Therefore, the first member, when n is equal to 1, is CH4. It is called methane. The second member is C2H6, ethane. The third member, C3H8, propane. Just be adding CH2 and you'll be getting it, butane, and so on and so forth. Alkanes usually have single bonds and they are termed saturated compounds because they have single bonds and they don't collect more atoms to their molecule again. Therefore, alkanes show little reactivity compared to other members, other homologous series. They show little reactivity. The basic properties and reactions they show are substitution reaction, because they cannot add anything, they can only substitute. Combustion, this is common to all organic compounds. And for the larger ones, they can undergo cracking. Let's look at substitution. It's a reaction in which a halogen atom replaces a hydrogen atom in an alkane in a stepwise manner, such that all the hydrogen atoms are replaced. For instance, methane plus chlorine can give you chloromethane and hydrochloric acid. Combustion, this is the burning of organic compound in oxygen to release carbon dioxide and water if the oxygen is sufficient, that is complete combustion. But if it is not sufficient, it gives carbon monoxide and water, or carbon and water. Carbon monoxide is very poisonous. It can suffocate human beings because it is colorless, odorless, and tasteless. It combines with oxygen in hemoglobin and causes suffocation. Then cracking is the last one. Cracking is a reaction in which large hydrocarbon molecule is split into smaller one. It's split into alkanes, smaller alkanes, and hydrogen, or smaller alkanes and alkanes. So it depends on how it is split. When it uses catalyst, it is called catalytic cracking. If it does not use catalyst, it is called thermal cracking. But it takes place at high temperature. At this stage, we have already reviewed the beginning of organic chemistry. We spoke about homologous series, which is the family of organic compounds. We define organic compound having carbon and hydrogen and other elements. Homologous series, family of organic compounds with similar properties. We talked about alkanes. The alkanes, we talked about their properties, combustion, cracking, and substitution. We talked about properties of homologous series, how they have same general formula, same functional group, similar chemical properties, and so on and so forth. I hope you have enjoyed today's lesson. Hope to see you next time for another review. I still remain Mr. Afolabi Olalekan. Bye.